Welcome to another one in our series of most watched recipe videos on YouTube videos. The problem is YouTube has disabled the sorting features, so we can no longer sort by date or by most viewed. So I had to come up with another plan, and I sort of thought, I've seen a video that I think will be the number one. So if we search beef short ribs, there you go. So the top video in this case is slow cooked beef short ribs by Gordon Ramsay, and it has 7.1 million views. Now, even if it isn't the number one video for this type of recipe, 7.1 million views is an absolute pile of views. I think most people would give their left arm to get 7.1 million views. So let's take a look and see what Chef Ramsay has to say.
Short ribs, and there's basically 5 to 6 bones across there. And as the short rib cooks, it sticks to that
okay.
Bone.
I think we're on to something. We're gonna give this a shot. It should be really good. So I know the premise of this recipe is that beef short ribs are supposed to be a cheaper cut of meat. I don't know what planet Chef Ramsay's living on, because here, these are only about $1 per pound different than prime rib. So, but I mean, the flavor's amazing, so I guess it's worth it. The first thing I've done is I've just started to salt and pepper these ribs. You want to salt and pepper them on all sides. And if they were attached, you just want to cut them off so that they're one bone and one bone only. And you're going to get some that have a lot of meat and some that have very little meat. Just cook them all the same. They all add flavor to this dish. Now, some olive oil in the bottom of the pan. And you want this pan sort of medium hot. It doesn't need to be screaming hot. We want to brown the beef, but you don't want to burn it. You don't want to introduce any sort of burnt flavors into your final meal. So that's induction. It's almost hot already. And we'll just start transferring this in. Beef side down, bone side up. And we're still going to brown on all sides, but at least start with the beef side down. This is a recipe with so few ingredients that every ingredient and every step is crucial to building the flavor. There's nowhere to hide, absolutely nowhere to hide. So get the best beef you can, use the best wine that you can, at least use a red wine that you would drink at the table. This is not a dish where you should cheap out on any ingredient. Okay, the beef is nice and brown, so in goes the tomato paste. And the top tip, if you're to take away anything from this video or Gordon Ramsay's video, is you need to fry out your tomato paste before you add any other ingredients. If you don't fry it out, it does have a very tinny or metallic taste. Some people will call it sharp. I think it tastes like the can. And just the act of frying it a little bit caramelizes some of the sugars and takes that tin flavor away. It doesn't take a whole lot, you just need a little bit. And you can sort of mix it in with the oil that's already in the pan. While that's frying off, I've got one head of garlic, and you just slide the knife through it, cut it in half. You don't have to peel it, but if some of the peel comes off, you just leave it behind. And I know that in my previous videos where I've done this, some people have gotten really mad. I'm disrespecting the garlic. You need to peel it. You need to take care of it. You don't. Right into the pan. Put it right in there with the tomato paste and the oil, and it just starts frying off with everything else. Okay, now the wine. We want the wine to come up to a boil. We want it to mix together with the tomato paste and the juices from the beef. And you want it to bubble away until it reduces by at least half. So this has turned into an incredibly nice thick sauce. Okay, last thing into the pan is beef stock. Now, if you make your own beef stock, go ahead and use it. You can use as dark a stock as you can make. If you're buying your stock from the grocery store, I would suggest not using beef stock. I've always found that in this type of preparation, as the purchased beef stocks reduce and concentrate in flavor, I find they give a really kind of strange off flavor to me. So if you're buying it, I would use chicken stock because the purchased chicken stock doesn't seem to have that flavor at the end. But it's your dish, you can do whatever you want. Now, lid on, I've got a preheated oven and I'm gonna stick this in and we'll check back when it's done. Okay, so we're just a few minutes from pulling the ribs out of the oven and Chef Ramsay finishes this dish with some pancetta and mushrooms. So we're just gonna fry off some pancetta here, get this going in this pan. And while that's cooking off, I'm going to slice up the mushrooms. And he just sort of halves and quarters them, depending on how big your mushrooms are. It's either half or a quarter will be just fine. And if you can't find pancetta, which I understand most people can't, bacon will be just fine. I mean, this is just to finish the dish, and I kind of think it's maybe a little over the top. But over the top might be just what we're looking for. Okay, the pancetta looks great. Let's get the mushrooms in. We'll just toss those around, get them coated with the bacon grease, and just have them release some of their liquid. Now, before we serve this, we want to get all of this sauce out of the bottom and just strain it to press the liquid out of the garlic buds. There's going to be so much flavor in there. A little bit of mushroom and pancetta on top. Kind of on top, kind of around. And then drizzle it with the sauce.
So Glen, you've got everything here. I see bacon, I see ribs. What is not in this?
Well, I wanted to do a really nice presentation because in my head, all I can hear is Chef Gordon Ramsay yelling at me that I'm a donkey. So I wanted to do his recipe proud. So I tried to make a nice presentation. I used the same kind of plate that he used in his video. This is the
number one.
I think.
Oh. That's right.
I think the number one watched beef rib recipe on YouTube. Something like 7 million views.
It's certainly up there.
Yeah,
it's a popular one.
There's enough that it's probably the most watched. So, I think it's a little over the top. There's a piece for you. I think the mushrooms and the bacon are a little over the top, but I think that's probably what makes the dish.
I think that piece might be too big for me.
Oh, okay.
I might make it smaller. The bacon's a little too much for you?
Oh my.
Well, let me participate. Hold on. I don't know if over the top is the right answer for that. That's got some great flavor combinations.
It's amazing. Go ahead. It's another recipe where there's nowhere to hide. You've got beef ribs, you've got wine, you've got beef stock, salt, pepper, and a little bit of tomato. There's no...
Oh, really? So it is that simple. I didn't...
Yeah. And a bulb of garlic. But there's very few... It's another one of those very few ingredients with an explosion of flavor because the method is good.
Ah. Is that the key? So that's how all the flavors got inside.
Yeah. It's the method.
Well, way to go. We like it.
So, Chef Gordon Ramsay...
Is it worth the effort? Is your question? I mean, it's pretty... So
there's not a lot of effort. I mean, it comes together really quickly. It does sit in the oven for 3 hours.
Oh, that's not effort. That's just time.
That's just time.
You just kind of peek at it.
There is a huge amount of flavor. I think the trade-off comes from beef ribs not being as cheap as they used to be. And it's almost the same price as prime rib.
Yeah, so at this... Yeah.
So well, at this point, you got to have to make that trade-off. I mean...
Well, and then eating meat generally can be very expensive.
Yes.
And I totally understand that, which is why this is such a rare event in our house.
So if... I saw beef ribs on sale. This is something that I would definitely do.
Okay. Do it and do it right. If you've got the treat of having beef ribs,
do it right.
Do it right.
Do this. And also, this is just a great base recipe. that you could layer other flavors on top if you really wanted to. You don't have to. That's the thing, you don't have to. This is so amazing. But if you wanted to, you could.
Okay, so now I'm going to ask another question.
Yep.
Could you take this same methodology and apply it to other types of meat, and would you think you'd be as successful?
Any meat that you would stew.
So anything yes. that's a stewable. So any, almost any type of beef.
Any beef that you would put in a stew pot, you could do this way.
Okay.
Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.
Enjoy.